Let us continue today's examples here. A few more examples on tables. So as you can see here, the output is visible on the browser here. We will try to draw, we'll try to code for this particular structure. So you can see here, we will require heading. The first row will act as a heading and also the first column. The vertical is called the column and the horizontal is the row. But we need to keep the first cell of this table to be empty. So let us try to do this example here. So can you help me to do these examples? Let us have the output here so that we are able to do it simultaneously here. So first of all, we will require a table tag. So let us also give the border for the table. We will close this table tag. So here we need to start with this particular structure. So first of all, we will require one row, right? So let us have the tr tag for the first row and let me end this first row, the tag for this. Now you observe here the first row, the first cell is empty and the following three headings, the following three columns are displayed as headings. So now which tag do I need to make use here if I need to display the headings?
TH.
Okay. So we'll make use of the TH tag. Let me write the content there. Let me give the heading. Similarly, I need two more, correct? So we'll just change this content inside. So let me save this and let me try to check how the output is going to be visible now. So we have got this heading, but we need the first cell to be empty. We need this first cell to be empty. So what we can do is we can just write a blank TH tag. We'll write a TH tag which will not contain anything, which will not contain any heading inside. Let us come back here and refresh this. So you can see we have got an empty cell. Okay. We have got an empty cell here. Let us continue with these three more rows at the bottom. Okay, so let me create another row here. Now, within this row, which is the first tag that I require here for breakfast, the first cell, I will require another TH tag. Now, what about these three cells? Which tag do I require for these?
TD.
Okay. Correct. So, we'll have a TD tag and we will just write the data inside our TD tag. We'll change the content inside. We also need to end our TR. We need to end the row tag. We'll come back here and refresh this. So we have got the first empty cell. We have got heading here, the first column heading, and then the respective cells. So similarly, these two blocks we need to do. So we can have the same code again. Another row, and the heading here is going to be lunch, and we will just have to change this contents. Similarly, another row, and here the heading has to be changed to dinner and the respective values. Okay, so let us save this, go back here and refresh this. So we have got two more cells. Now here you can see this table example, right? So this is attached, right? You can see, or you will feel that right below this heading, a table is going to be attached. So for that, we have a property that we can specify in the table. Okay, instead of giving this heading, we'll take off this heading. Inside our table, we have a tag called as caption. We can give the heading inside this caption tag. So here we will write the table example title, and let us close our caption tag inside the, see, observe here, it is inside the table tag. I have written the caption tag. Save, go back and refresh this. So now you can see you have the heading, like it is just for this particular table. So below the heading you will have the table. Now after this understanding about the tables, let us try to understand the properties that we can specify for the tables. Like you must have heard of the terms cell padding and cell spacing. Okay, if not, you find out and come, what is the difference between these two? What is the difference between cell padding and cell spacing? Then if you want to align the data inside these cells, you want them to be left aligned, center aligned, or you want them to be vertically placed at the top, vertically at the bottom. So with which properties can we do them? Let us have a look at this example here. Let me run the code. Have a look here. Okay. The property that I have specified. First of all, you identify that we have this table just with two rows and two columns. Just there are two rows and two columns. Then the first row is acting as the heading here. And the second row is containing the data. So you have two TR tags. In the first TR tag, you will have the TH tags, because these are the headings. Then in the second row tag, you will just have the data, TD. Okay. Then I have specified a property for the table. You can have a look here. I have specified the border. I have also specified cell padding, and I have given the numeric value 5. Let me change this to 15. Let me change the cell padding to 15. And I'm going to refresh this. So now observe how the data is getting displayed. Similarly, we have another property that is called as cell spacing. Okay, the same program. This is the code. The same program, two rows. The first one is the heading and second is the data. The only property change here is cell spacing. Instead of cell padding, I have made use of cell spacing and given the value 5. Let me also make this value to be 15, and let me refresh here. So this is the example for cell spacing. This is the example for cell padding. So can you make out the difference and tell me what is cell spacing? What is cell padding? Ajay? Is Ajay Zard in the meeting?
Cell spacing means space between two cells or tables.
Yes, ma'am.
Not two tables. Only single table we have. Between two cells.
Columns.
Okay, two columns. Okay. What about cell padding? Shivam Sapre, is there in the meeting?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you answer?
Yes, ma'am. The distance between the cell borders.
The content and the cell borders.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so observe here, all of you. When I gave the property cell padding, okay, the content, you can see the spacing here between the content, that is from the last letter H up till this border, the space has increased. that is cell padding, space between the content and its border. But when I say cell spacing, as your friend answered here for cell spacing, what did he say? There is no space between the content and the border, but you can see space between the two cells. The two cells have been, the space between these two cells have increased. So you can specify such properties for your tables. Also, you have some more properties. Let me just run this code here. Have a look at this table. You have three rows. Again, the first cell is kept empty. So which means in the first TR tag, we will have a blank TH tag. When you come to the second row, you have a heading TH. Now you observe the content or the data that is there. This text is left aligned. This is center aligned, whereas the last one is right aligned. If you have a look at the property V align, the last row, it is called as V align. Vertically, how do you want to align your data? Vertically, whether you want the data to be placed in center of the text, whether you want it to be at the top, touching the top border, or you want it to touch the bottom border. Okay, so we have two more properties, that is align and V align. So let us try to do this example of align and V align. Let us clear out this particular data here. Let us give the caption. And the let us give the heading to be the same thing that you can see in the example here, the align and V align attributes or V align properties. Close your caption tag here. The next thing is, all we have to do is what? We will just have to have three rows, correct? Create three rows. First row is done. Let me have two more rows. Manisha, can you tell me what comes within my first row? Manisha Patil, are you there in the meeting? Roll number 695. I guess she's sleeping. She's plugged on the headphones. And some other background task is going on. Indra Bhushan?
Yes, ma'am. So what did you ask?
In the first row, what should be the next tag that we require if I need to create the similar output here? Have a look in the browser.
Yes, ma'am.
I need similar kind of output. So I have created three rows. What do I need to specify in my first row?
I'm not getting, ma'am.
You're not getting the question, or you're not able to get the answer?
Question only, ma'am.
Okay, I'll repeat the question again. Okay, this is the table which is displayed to you in the browser. Okay. The table is having three rows and has four columns. So in my code here, I have written three TR tags, which means I have created three rows. Now I need to fill up these rows. I need to create the cells. So how do I create this first row? How do I create this first row here? Which tag do I need to make use of?
Don't you, ma'am.
You people are not paying attention. Prajwal?
Yes, ma'am.
Tell me, what tag do I specify?
Ma'am, for that first empty tag, we have to use TH, ma'am.
Okay, let me
start with TH.
Okay, I've written a TH tag. What within the TH tag, what do I need to specify here?
Nothing, ma'am. There is nothing, ma'am. That's empty cell. So we have to nothing mentioned, ma'am.
Okay.
Next. Next, we have to start again with TH, and we have to write that column label and end that tag.
Okay. So here I will write column label.
Yeah, ma'am.
Okay. And so similarly, I need to create.
Yeah, ma'am. You have to go for the another one, still another one.
So altogether two. So here I need to have the heading as another one. This is for still another one. Fine. Now, Inder Bhushan, did you pay attention to this?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, can you help me to create my second row, this one? Can you help me with the tag? Were you not present for previous classes? Prashant is there in the class? Deepika? Roll number 674, Abhinand. Six 76, Aditi. Six 76.
Yes, ma'am.
Can you help me to create the next code here? Which tag is required for this particular row? Are you people following the table tag?
Ma'am, can you explain?
Yes, which one should I explain?
No, ma'am. I tell? I'm asking.
Oh, yeah. Please tell.
Yes, ma'am. So, ma'am, next will be table data, ma'am. Tag.
Table data, okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So,
the align label will be there, ma'am.
Fine. Done.
Yes, ma'am. Closing with the tag. And then the next tag will be again the table data.
Let me copy this. Okay. I need to change this to left. We'll specify the properties. Okay. First, let us have the content ready. I'll show you where you need to specify the property. Center. And another one is right. I want you to have a look at the output here. Okay, have this one. I'll run this code. See, something is missing. Observe this.
Ma'am, align should be in TH tag.
Correct.
It is bold.
It is a heading, right? It is bold, which means it is a heading. So this, we will make it TH, not TD. TD stands for data, table data. TH stands for table heading. Now, we are speaking about the property called as align. Within my TD tag, okay, I will write the property align. We have used this before. And I will specify this alignment, the properties alignment, the value to be left. Within this TD tag, again, I'll make use of the same property. And I need the text to be in the center. So the value is center. Again, in this same property, just the value is going to be changed to right. Let us save this. You observe here, within the tags, with I need to give double quotes, just the same way that we have done previously. Give your property name, right equal to symbol, in the double quotes, give its value. Okay, let us refresh and check now. So you can see here align, since you have given in heading, it has turned again changed to bold. The text is also properly aligned now to left, right, and center. So this is about aligning the text in a single line, okay, not vertically alignment. If I need vertical alignment from top to bottom, how do I do it? We'll create another row now. Okay, let me just have the, let me copy this same row. We have already created here. Okay, so good. We'll directly have the first one. We need to give the table heading again. Inside the table heading, I'll write V-align. Now, in the TD tag, I will specify the property. The property name is what? What do you think is the property name? It is going to be V-align. V-A-L-I-G-N. This is the property name. Let me specify the values. Okay, it takes three values. One is default. If I do not specify anything, like here, let me not specify any property and let me not specify any value. Let me write here as default. The second property that it takes is you can align the text to top of the cell. Let me write the text and close this particular TD tag. And the third property that the property we align takes is bottom. Okay. It takes the property value as bottom. We'll close this and then specify a text and close this particular TD tag. Now, if I save this and refresh here in the browser, see, we have not got any effects here, which means we are missing out here on some tags, or we have not closed a tag properly. Just have a look. Are we missing out on any tags? Let us try to run this on a different browser and check. Here also we are, the effect for the V align is not displayed. Okay. Let us just have this full screen and check out for where we are missing out on a tag.
Ma'am, you have written that V align, it should be aligned in that TD tag.
No. When we talk about two properties there, V align and align. Okay.
Okay.
The property name is correct. Wait, let us just try to, let me just give a BR tag here and check. Okay. Now can you see, you're able to see the effect now. I just gave a BR tag. Can you tell me what changes happened, why we are able to why the effects are getting applied now? Observe here. If I remove this BR tag, okay, this BR tag is removed. See, now again it is coming in a single line. If I apply the BR tag here, go back to the browser and refresh. Now we are able to see the difference. Default, the text is aligned in the center, that top border and bottom border, we do not touch. Top means it touches the top, the text touches the topmost border, and bottom is the text touching the bottom border. Now we are able to see the difference. The thing is, this text we align is a very small word. Okay, if we give a BR tag, no, we are able to make it to come on the next line. The text is expanding. It is creating a blank empty space here. So that is why we are able to see these effects. when we make use of this vAlign property. So these are the two properties which you can use for a table tag. Okay, so this is it for today. You drop in your attendance, and any doubts you have, you can ask. In the next class, I hope that the students whose names I called out will be able to answer. Abhinandan, Aditi, Indra Bhushan, Deepika.
Yes, ma'am.